Afternoon Talk on SAFM.
Right, lots of, you know, please certainly welcome that more on this issue. If you have any thoughts on the debate about nationalism, I'll certainly take the emails, ashraf@safm.co.za, and if you're tweeting about it, just use the hashtag SAFM so we get a sense of what your thoughts may well be on this issue. Right, let's move on then. Hopefully you watched last night's special assignment show, which was titled No Woman's Land, produced by Asanda Magaga. But tell you what, and Gordon Osnari as well, it covered a story of Zimbabwean women crossing into this country, to South Africa. And we're not talking xenophobia now, not at all. But it covers that story as they cross the river and you have South Africans on the other side, let's call them gangs, who in fact are there to loot, to plunder, to injure, and to rape. And as the story unfolded, you could see it was not isolated. It happened over and over again. There was just so much anecdotal evidence around that. So I want to get your thoughts on this issue. Just, I mean, it happened a while back. It is sort of it's an award-winning documentary, which was actually first shot in 2010. The question then is, you know much about it since 2010. What has actually happened with Zimbabweans trying to cross the river to get into South Africa? And what protection are they being given? We're talking of people crossing legitimately, of course. But even if it's illegitimate, should they then be in a position where they're completely vulnerable to the point where they know they're going to get to the promised land, but to get to the land, they're going to be raped? It's as horrific as that. So your opinion on that, 1089 1104207. I know many people tweeted, and you can also check out the hashtag special assignment, by the way. Many people tweeted around that one there. Let's, however, start with a chat to Jacob Matakanya, who's the director of the Musina Legal Advice Office. Jacob, thanks so much for your time. Good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon.
Yeah. Well, what are your thoughts, A, in terms of, because what came through from last night's show, and certainly from the many Facebook comments and tweets, is like, what sort of protection are these women getting?
Yeah, thanks. The issue of this woman who crossing the Zimbabwean border coming to South Africa, it's a problem because they've got not any form of protection. First, from their country of origin. Mm-hmm. Second, from the country they think maybe is going to be they are Ghanaian. They don't have any protection. All these horrible things started immediately. They want to cross the river to South Africa. These gangs is not only in South Africa. The gangs is a syndicate between the gang in Zimbabwe and the gang in South Africa.
So they work together?
Yes, because the gang in Zimbabwe, they are lowering these people as if they're going to help them to cross the river to South Africa, where they will get people who will help them to go whatever in the to go any place in the country, where they'll get help. Instead, these people who, from Zimbabwe, they'll take them immediately when they're in the middle of the river, Limpopo. They'll be marked, they'll be raped, they'll even be being killed. And those who survived that in the middle, they'll come to South Africa, where they'll get another group, where they'll do the same thing to them.
Wow.
But now, the problem is, you talk about protection. The issue is, we've got two countries, South Africa and Zimbabwe, which the bilateral agreement with other issues. But for this crime happening in the river, they don't care about it.
Okay, so since then, because the original documentary flighted 2 years ago, in fact, since then you're saying, in fact, nothing's changed?
You know, it's long been in the media. We go into the TV show, we go to the radio, like today, speaking the same language. The plight of the people who've been pushed in the river Limpopo. Even I still remember last year, the commissioner of Limpopo, police commissioner, he visited the area in Limpopo. He saw by himself what is happening there, right? He even commented that at least the thing is happening in Limpopo. It's a well-organized crime because the people are doing that. It seems they've been trained soldiers. So, and then we're asking them, can two countries have a joint operation to deal with that? They said it's not the jurisdiction of of policing, because they said it's where they called no man's land. That is the language or the term which does not make them to protect those people.
Indeed.
They said between Limpopo in the bottom of the river, it's a man's land. It's not South Africa. It's not Zimbabwe.
Mm.
So, but here we're talking about human beings who originally they're from Zimbabwe. They're Zimbabwean citizens.
Mm.
When they're in South Africa, they're protected by the Declaration of Human Rights internationally.
Mm. Mm.
They're human. The South African government must take care of them. Let me tell you something what is happening. If these people, they can identify a perpetrator in South Africa, and they go to the police, they said, we have seen that perpetrator, where were? The police will say, no, yes, we can arrest this, but we cannot prosecute this person because this the case has not happened in the South African border.
Oh, my goodness.
It was in no man's land. It's not our jurisdiction. Check, this is a perpetrator. They identified the person. That person cannot be arrested.
Mm. All right. Let me also invite callers. I'll get to Tabiso in just a second. 0891104207. My guest is Jacob Matakanye, who is the director of the Musina Legal Advice Office. We're talking about no woman's land, so land that's certainly not for women or women. As per last night's special assignment show, you've seen that they're trying to cross the border from Zimbabwe to South Africa, and as the point made, that in fact you get these gangs who set them up, sort of as the good fairy godmother, but they tend to be the wicked witches, setting them up to sort of cross the river, and sort of midway through in this no woman's land, the other gangs sort of meet them, and they're raped, and they get to South Africa, and they're raped, and it seems like it's an ongoing story. What are your thoughts about it? You could be a Zimbabwean, you could be a South African who knows much more about it. You could also be somebody from Home Affairs or the SAPS in terms of what your thoughts may be, legal opinion as well, all of that absolutely welcome. I just want to get to, well, let's get to the callers, in fact, Tabiso in West Dean. Good afternoon, what's your point?
Oh, thank you for taking my call.
That's a pleasure.
I just want to dispel one thing. On a sadder note, that this is sadly happening. It is not South Africans. I'm not trying to defend anyone.
Mm-hmm.
But there is a gang of Zimbabweans called the Goomba Goomba.
Right, yeah. A lot of reference made to them last night.
It is Zimbabweans hurting Zimbabweans. So to say it is South Africans hurting Zimbabweans coming in, I think that's a lie. And it should be condemned in a strong possible
terms. But let's say even if it is Zimbabweans, if it's on South African soil, I mean...
It is happening on South African soil, but it is Zimbabweans hurting their own citizens, then coming into the country, still even there are trucks that are used. Some of those trucks have even been involved in accidents. You understand? Driven by Zimbabweans, taking Zimbabwean women into the country. There's also been elements of human trafficking being perpetrated by the very same Goomba Goombas. So to insinuate that it is South Africans who are trafficking Zimbabwean women into the country, I think it's a fallacy. It needs to be condemned.
Okay, and you've certainly done that. Thanks so much for that call, Tabiso. Right, I'll take a few more calls. I also want to read your tweets. There are many tweets, I can tell you now. Vikunduku from Brakpan. Good afternoon. Hi.
Hi, Asha.
Yes.
Look, I don't think your programs about xenophobia are, building a good relationship. You know, South African blacks have been the most advanced socially, culturally, economically than the rest of the Africa. In 1994, when the rest of Africa flocked into the country here, they found us already at a high level of economic advancement. We accommodated them. Every time South Africans are being attacked of being xenophobic. Just recently, you heard the Nigerian ambassador saying South Africans are xenophobic.
Yes.
And yet in Nigeria, thousands of people are being killed almost every day. Coming to this very issue that you are talking about today, that there are gangs of South Africans raping foreigners. It's not true, but South Africans respect themselves, both emotionally and sexually. You understand?
No, but you see, you're making...
Ashura, let's talk the truth here. You heard Zimbabweans who have been housed in the Methodist Church. And they were raped by Zimbabweans who are staying with them in the very same Methodist Church.
Okay.
Now, where do you put in South Africans here? Every time it is said that South Africans are xenophobic, look, South Africans are socially advanced than the rest of Africa. You understand? And we are the best, whether they like it or not. These people in the rest of the African countries, they are killing each other in every African country. And yet, when they come to us here, they say we're xenophobic.
Okay, can I?
This is not true.
Right, can
and
I?
All this kind of attitude, Asha, I want to tell you, you're not going to win the hearts and the minds of the South African blacks.
Okay.
South African blacks are heartful, I want to tell you, about what is going on every time about xenophobia.
Okay, let me...
South
let
Africans
me...
love themselves, right, and they're proud of themselves.
Can I just say something very quickly? Are you still there? You're
yes.
gone. Okay, just say. Let me say something very quickly. I think this program that we're talking about now is certainly not about xenophobia. What we're talking about, and you need to give me a chance, what we're talking about here is the fact that people are crossing over and they're not being protected. Whether, and you may well be right, whether these gangs are Zimbabweans or South Africans. That's the one thing. The other part, and I certainly know about the comments made about Nigeria last week, I think to say that all South Africans are xenophobic, I think is ridiculous, because I'm certainly South African and I'm not xenophobic, and you're probably in the same boat as me. But to say that none of them are xenophobic is also ridiculous. Similarly with every other nation in the world, isn't it?
Look, Asha, your program that you have just finished off right now,
yeah.
you're talking of nationalism and xenophobia.
Yes.
You want to link the two as if national pride generates xenophobia.
Yeah, we asked that
this
question.
This is not true. This is not true. Your guest there never mentioned anything about the European national development, that the Visigoths, the barbarians, used to kill each other in building up the European state. And yet he wants to become an expert about blacks in Africa.
Okay.
But what I say here is that I don't think every time we read stories about xenophobia about us South Africans, that makes us good. Look, I want to tell you straight here.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of publications that are coming about xenophobia.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to tell you straight, South Africans won't read that material,
all
including
right.
the very same film made by that Nigerian guy about xenophobia. We won't read that rubbish because every time we're being reflected as devils, and yet they found us here in our own country and very loving.
Okay, you made your point, and thanks so much.
Them.
Okay,
you
I'm
can
gonna...
go around any town, any city in this country, and look at how these towns and cities are. And yet, the South Africans, black South Africans, who have never enjoyed the privilege of being in towns, staying in towns, kept by the poor, they have never, at any stage,
okay.
been found to live in
I'll
towns.
Tell you what,
and
leave.
Foreigners All are right. everywhere in towns.
Okay, you made your point. I'm going to move on. No, you've made your point. I'm going to have to cut you off only because I need to give other callers a chance and I can't allow you just to be the only guest on the show. You've made your point. Thanks so much for that. I tell you what, I'm very happy if you leave your number here because maybe we'll discuss it some other time in terms of do we, in fact, does the media perhaps encourage and perpetuate xenophobia itself? Now, that's an interesting discussion.
Okay.
In terms of the point you made, I think that's very, very important indeed that you have a view indeed. I certainly want to get Jacob... Matakanya to comment on that. Jacob, yeah?
Yes. Asha, can I comment after the last speaker?
All right.
About this concern.
Yeah.
What we're saying, we are not saying, as I earlier indicated, this horrible thing started right from in Zimbabwe. Before these people crossed the river, the people in Zimbabwe, they allowed them that they were going to help them. Immediately they're in the middle of the river with those Zimbabweans. It's where they've been raped, they've been killed. We didn't say South Africans are killing them, are raping them. So when we're saying this thing happened before they come to South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
we're saying there's a syndicate in which people are, those people are in South Africa. We're not saying that they're South Africans.
Absolutely. And that's a point you've made already.
Exactly.
Yes. Yeah.
We're not saying, because my understanding now, what we're saying now is not, we're not talking about xenophobia. We're talking about the attack which is happening in Limpopo River.
And that's what we're talking
about.
And
we're saying this is done by the, as I was saying, that's mapping right in the river, not South Africans.
Okay.
We as South Africans now, as he was indicating, we've got shelters to take care of them where they can go, they go for any treatment by the South African government. The issue is at least where they've been attacked in the river. And I was not saying. No women's land.
Indeed. Okay, I'm going to get to three calls. Please, you need to be very, very brief, sort of one specific point only, because we just don't have enough time, unfortunately. Tsebiso in Bloemfontein, let's get to you first. Hi.
Hello, Ashra.
Yes,
thank you for taking my call.
It's a pleasure. Right, quick one, if you don't mind.
Yes, I watched the program yesterday. But anyway, my analysis, by the way, by the look of things, I've noticed that it seems as if when the Zimbabweans cross the river. These atrocities are committed on the side of South Africa. Now, my concern is the Zimbabweans are committing this kind of crimes in South Africa. That means disrespecting South African laws. Why are they not being done before they cross the river? Mainly after crossing the river, then these things are happening. The point that I'm trying to make here is foreigners disrespecting South African laws, because things that they are doing here, they are afraid of doing them in their countries.
Okay, interesting one. I'm going to move on. Clearly, as I said, time very much against us. Kathy, just one quick comment, please. Hi.
Hello, hi.
Yes, Kathy.
Can I just make a point? I've just answered the front gate.
Okay.
And a man that I gave some help to a little while ago, as the second person in the today who's come and showed me bruises and everything else and said, everything that you gave me last week, I was attacked, and everything that you gave me, they stole.
Okay, well, what is that going to do with what we're talking about? That's what I need to know. I'm sorry about that.
The thing is that you don't need to go to the borders and everything else. This hooliganism is rife.
Okay, got that. Thanks for that, Kathy. Right, Ojo in Heidelberg. Hi, quick one again, please.
Hi, Shav, how are you?
I'm very good. Quick one, please. 30 seconds.
Please, I want to speak quick because of the time. The guy that spoke that about Nigeria, I wish I can know that guy details. If he can have money, I will buy a ticket for him in June. He must go to Nigeria and stay there for 1-2 weeks. When he come back, he will see Nigeria is not a xenophobia. Not every South Africa is a xenophobia. My wife is a South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Many people, when I tell them I'm a kwerekwere, they say, no, you are not a kwerekwere. We are the same thing. How can that guy come to the national radio and speaking cack?
Okay, got that.
I'm
thanks.
Sorry to say that language. Thank you.
You can't. We can't use that sort of language, really. There's just been some bad language on the air today. But we don't mind your views, but you certainly don't mind. We mind you having the bad language. Tony in Krugersdorp, you're the last caller. Hi. Quick one.
Very quickly, I'd just like to dissociate myself from the previous South African who phoned in with absolute hysteria and flipping anger in the guy's voice. I mean, that's exactly what leads to xenophobia, making vague statements that South Africans are better than the rest of Africa. Just for his information, Malawi has, in every single index that's been had over the last 10 years by the UN, been shown to have a higher standard of education than South African. South Africans. Yes, we are wealthier, but that certainly doesn't make us better than any of us.
Indeed. We can't really speak in absolutes. I agree with that. Tony, thanks so much for that one. Right, Jacob Matakanya, just to wrap up in 30 seconds, if you can, please, just where do we go next with this one here? What should we be asking?
Yeah, really, what we're asking is the first question, the protection of the vulnerable woman while crossing because of a certain reason. We need the two governments, Zimbabwe and South Africa, to come with a mechanism to protect those victims. There's no way you can say there's no man's land. Whereas when you talk about the borders, it was created by other people, but we can able. Let's come with a mechanism of protecting. Because if the two countries can go in, because those people are there, they can see them in the river. They can raid and get them. And some people, as I'm saying, they can be identified.
Something needs to be done, whoever they are, South Africans or Zimbabweans. Got that point. Thanks so much for that, Jacob Matakanya, the director of the Musina Legal Advice Office. Thanks for the couldn't take any more calls. By the way, any further comments, you can use the hashtag just SAFM or special assignment as well, and email me with pleasure, ashraf@safm.co.za.